Hello friends, welcome to my channel Math Segment. Today let us solve some more multiple choice questions from the chapter Arithmetic Progression, which is based on SSLC Board Exam 2021. If you like my video, please like, share and subscribe. Let us start solving the sums from today's video. The first question: three numbers are in AP, the middle number is 13, the numbers are. So here they have given you the four options, where this question is different from the other questions where we have solved in our two videos. So here we have to find out that three numbers are in AP. AP means that when the sequence is having the difference same, then it is an AP. But here the middle number is given as 13. So in these options, we have all the numbers in the middle is 30. Now we need to find out whether which option has the same difference. So 13 minus 1 is 12, 17 minus 13 is 4. So this is not the option. 13 minus 8 is 5, 18 minus 13 is 5. So this is the right answer, but anyway we'll check. 13 minus 7 is 6, 17 minus 13 is 4, 13 minus 9 is 4, 19 minus 13 is 6. So that means here we are getting the difference for this option is 5 and 5. For both we are getting same difference. So the B option we can take it as right option. So that means the three numbers in AP are 8, 13 and 18. Let's solve the next question. The five terms A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 respectively of an AP are 4, 8, 12, 16, 16 and 20. Which of the following equations are not true? So see here, they've asked you not true. Here they have given the A1 value, A2 and A3 up to A5. So here they have given you the options and you have to substitute the values in this equation and find out which equations are not true. So let us solve the question. So first question for A, what is our A1? A1 is 4, A5 is 20. Minus A2 is 8 is equal to A4 is 16. 4 plus 20 is 24. 24 minus 18 is 16. B. A5 is 20 plus A2 is 8 is equal to A4 is 16. A1 is 4. So 20 plus 8 it is 28, 16 plus 4 is 20. So this is not equal. But anyway, we'll check out this also. A3 is 12 plus A4 is 16 minus A2 is 8 and A5 is 20. So 12 plus 16 is 28 minus 8 is equal to 20. So this is 20 is equal to 20. So this is also equal. Now next B, that is A3 is 12 plus A4 is 16 is equal to A2 is 8 and A5 is 20. 12 plus 16 is 28 and 8 plus 20 is 28. So here the options 16 is equal to 16 and this is not equal. So that means this is not true. The option here, that is C question. And the option C is the right answer. The next question. My son's age, my father's age, my age are in AP. If my age is 40 and my son's age is 10, the age of my father is. So that means they all are in AP. So that means we have understood the son's age as 10 and my age as 40. So you have to find out the father's age. So that means to find out the father's age, you have to be in AP. So to find it out in AP, that means totally we have three of them. That means how many of them are there? N is 3. So now here you have to find out the difference. So first you find the difference, how much it is? That is A2 minus A1. A2 is 40 minus 10. So that is what? 30. Now because since it is, you have to find out the third term, then you have to write A plus 2D, that is A is 10 plus 2 and D we found it as 30. So 10 plus 2 30s are, it is 60. So 10 plus 60, it is 70. So the option C is 70. That means my father's age is 70. So the next question, 3x plus 2, 5x minus 3 and 4x plus 7 are the three consecutive terms of an AP. Then the value of x is what? You have to find the value of x. So now here the terms, how many terms are given? 1, 2, 3, that is nothing but n is 3. The first term is 3x plus 2. And we have to find out the difference, that is a2 minus a1. So a2 is 5x minus 3 minus in the formula, and a1 is 3x plus 2. So 5x minus 3, minus into plus is minus 3x, minus into plus is minus 2. So we have like terms here and the like constants here. 5x minus 3x gives you 2x, minus 3 minus 2 gives you minus 5. So what is that? That is your D. So now with this help, and then now we can use the formula to find out the D is equal to 2x minus 5. To find the x value, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So here your last term is 4x plus 7 and your first term is 3x plus 2 plus n value is 3 and d value is 2x minus 5. So this becomes 4x plus 7, this becomes 3x plus 2 plus 3 minus 1 is 2 and 2x minus 5. So 4x plus 7, 3x plus 2, we need to substitute, remove the bracket. So plus 2 into 2x is 4x, less into minus, minus 2 5s are 10. So this is 4x plus 7. So here you have like terms, 3x plus 4x is 7x, plus 2 minus 10 is minus 8. So now we will bring the variables one side and the constants one side. So since it here you have a bigger variable, I am keeping it here and bringing the smaller variable that side. So it becomes minus 4x. And I am keeping this 7 here only, minus 8 I am bringing to this side, so it will become of plus 8. So 7 plus 8 is 15 and 7x minus 4x gives you 3x. So we want only x. So what happens? This 3 comes down and you get the x. 3 goes in 15 5 times. So we found the x value as 5. So the option 5 is in C. So this is the right option. The next question. The angles of a triangle are in AP. The smallest angle is 20. Then the remaining two angles are. So this question is about the triangle. So let us draw one small triangle. We know the properties of triangle, where sum of all the angles in a triangle is equal to 180 degree. So now we had to find out, since one angle is given and that is the other two angles, that means you had to use the formula where we are using the first four terms. So a plus d plus a plus 2d is equal to 180. We have put in between plus sign because it is sum of all the angles. So that's why we are adding this angles. Plus 180. So A is, we know, 20 plus 20 plus D value we don't know. Again we know 20, we don't know 2D is equal to 180. So 20 plus 20 plus 20. 20 plus 20 is 40. 40 plus 20 is 60. Plus 2D plus D is 3D is equal to 180. So now since these are the constant values, so 3D is equal to 180 minus 60. So here that is 3D is equal to 120. We don't want 3D, we want only D. So we will keep the D here and send this 3 down. So 3 goes in 120. How many times? It goes 40 times. So now here D is 40. So the sum has not finished because we had to find out the three angles. So by using the first four terms formula, we will use it. A plus D, A plus 2D. So A is, what is our A? A is 20. So that means it becomes 20 plus D is 40 and A is 20 plus 2 into 40. So this remains the same. This 20 plus 40 gives you 60. This gives you 20 plus 20 plus 2 into 40 is 80. So this is 20, this is 60, and this is 100. So these are the three angles where we found out. So where is 60 and 100? It is in the first option. So A option is the correct answer. So the next question, it is based on the topic sum of first n terms of an AP. So here from this, the first question we are solving is which is the correct form of the formula for finding the sum of n terms of an AP. So in the formula list I have discussed sum of n terms of an AP. You have to choose the correct formula from this. So here n by 2 into a plus n minus 1 into d, it is the wrong option. Whereas here n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So this is the nth term formula, sum of n terms. So I can take b option as the correct option, where the c and d we have not come across these formulas, we have not learned in this chapter. Let's solve the next question. The sum of the nth terms of an AP is 2n square plus 5n and its CD is 6. Then the first term is what? So here, from the given equation, we can find the sum of n terms of an AP is the equation. So Sn is 2n square plus 5n and D is given as 6. S1 is, you have to find it out. So now we know what the equation is given first of all. So that is Sn is equal to 2n square plus 5n. From the given equation, we need not find out the D, or we have to find out according to the question, we have to find out A, but here D is not required. Just to confuse you, they have given this D. So now what we have to find out? We have to find out S1. So in place of 1, in place of n, you can put 1 and substitute the value. So 2, 1 square is 1 only. So 2 1s are 2, 5 1s are 5. So 2 plus 5 is 7. So this is what? S1 is 7. We got the required information. So D option is the right answer. So let's solve the next question. If an is equal to 2n plus 1, find S3. That means an, they have given the equation, and S3 you have found out. But in the previous question, they had given the equation for Sn, and you have to find out the first term. But this question is little bit different from the previous question. So here they have given you an is equal to 2n plus 1. So now we have to find out S3. So we don't know how to find out S3. So now we have to learn that S1 is always equal to A1, whereas S2 is equal to A1 plus A2. S3 is equal to A1 plus A2 plus A3. So keeping that means in this concept, you must know the first three terms. So to find out the first three terms, that means we have to assume the n value as 1, 2 and 3. So let us take n value as 1. So 2 into 1 plus 1. 2 1s are 2 plus 1 is 3. So A2 we will do it. 2 into 2 plus 1. 2 2s are 4 plus 1. It is 5. So A3 is 2 into 3 plus 1. 2 3 is a 6 plus 1, 7. So these three options means find values we have found out. Now we have to substitute in S3 so that we will get the value of S3. So S3 is nothing but A1 plus A2 plus A3. So what is A1? 3. What is A2? 5. And A3 is 7. So 5 plus 3 plus 5 is 8. 8 plus 7 is 15. So where is the option 15? So it is in C. So this is the correct option. Let us solve the next question. The 8th term of an AP is 25. The sum of the first 15 term is what? We have to find it out. That means the 8th term means A8 is 25 and S15 we need to find it out. So here to find it out, so that means here we know what is A8 is given as 25. We have to find out S15. So that means Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So here that means S15 we have to find it out. So 15 divided by 2 into 2a we don't know plus 15 minus 5 and D also we don't know. So S15 is equal to 15 by 2 into 2A plus 14D. So S15 is equal to 15 by 2 we cannot cancel, so we are keeping as it is. In these two, 2 is common, so A plus 7D. So this 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. So S15 is equal to 15 into A plus 7D. So now here A8, here A plus 7D is there and they have given the 8th term. So T8 we can write it as A plus 7D. That is nothing but 25. A8 is 25. So that is A plus 7D is nothing but 25. So here I can write it as S15 is equal to 15 into A plus 7D is given. So I have to write 15 into A plus 7D is 25. So 15 into 25 is 375. So where is the option 375? It is in C is the correct option. So the next question, if A12 is equal to 37, D is 5, find A and 12. So that means A12 is given as 37, which you can write it as A12 as A plus 11D. So that is nothing but 37 is equal to A plus 11D. Then next, D is given as 3. You have to find it out A and you have to find it out S12. Okay. So now from the given information, I can use this value equation, that is A12 is equal to A plus 11D, and I can find it out the D value. So A12 is 37 is equal to A, we don't know, plus 11, and D value is 3. So 37 is equal to A plus 33. So these are the constant values, we will shift it to the other side. So 37 minus 33 is 4. So A value is 4. Now you have to know what is your S12 value. So to find out S12 value, we know what is N also. N is how much here? It is 12. So we know N, we know A, and we know the last term. That is, the, we have to find it out. So that is N by 2 into A plus N. So S12 is equal to 12 divided by 2 into A is, we found it as 4, and L is nothing but AN, that is 37. So S12 is equal to, sorry, we can cancel here. That is 2 goes in 12 6 times. So it is 6 into 41. So S12 is equal to 6 is 246. So 4 and 246, because A and S12. So option 4 and 246. 4 and 246 is here. So you can tick the answer as D. The next question, given A3 is equal to 15, S10 is 125, find D and A10. So now given information, S10 is given as 125 and A3 is given as 15, and D we have to find out and A10 we have to find out. So now here, first they have given A3 as 15. So I can write this as A plus 2B is equal to 15. So this becomes our first equation. And the next they have given as S10 is equal to 125. So I can write Sn is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. So Sn is nothing but here S10. So 10 divided by 2, we don't know A value, plus N is again here it is 10 minus 1, and D also we don't know. So 2 goes in 10 5 times. S10 value is given as 125 is equal to 5 into 2A plus 9, 10 minus 1 is 9D. Okay, so we wanted, so this is nothing but the, I have explained in the previous question, 2A is equal to 16 by giving an example. So same way, so this is nothing but 2A, this is 16. So I can take this as 16 and then can bring this here as 5. So this becomes 2A plus 9D. So 5 goes in 25, how many times? 25 times. So 25 is equal to 2A plus 9D. So this is my second equation. So by equating 1 and 2. So here 1 we have A plus 2D is equal to 15, and second equation 2A plus 9D is equal to 25. So again here, see, the both the terms has to be same, both the variables has to be same. So since it is not same, we are going to use cross multiplication. So 2 into a is 2a plus 2 into 2d is 4d, 15 into 2 is 30, 1 into 2a is 2a plus 1 into 9d is 90, 1 into 25 is 25. Now because the two terms are same, so I can change the sign to eliminate one term. So I am eliminating here, the greater number sign is minus, so I am putting minus and subtracting the numbers. The greater number sign is plus, so I'm just putting plus and subtracting the numbers. It is 5. We don't want 5d, we want only d. So d is equal to 5 divided by minus 5. So that becomes 1. So that means d value is 1. So you found out this. Now you have to find it out. That is d you found out. Then to find it out, a10, then we have to know what is a10? A plus 9d. That means we should also know d value. So here to find a value, we know the d value, we'll find a value. So to find a value, you can take any equation, any two from these two equation, any one equation, and you can solve. We don't know a, we are finding out a, that is equal to 15. So a plus 2 and d is what we have found it out as minus 1 is equal to 15. So a plus into minus is minus 2 is equal to 15. So a is equal to, send this minus to that side. So 15 plus 2. So a is 17. So you got it a, you got it d. We can find it out a10 easily. So a10 is equal to a plus 9d. So a is 17 plus 9 into minus 1. So 17 plus into minus is minus 9. 17 minus 9 is 8. So here that means we have to find out what else? We have to find out d. D is minus 1 and then we have to find it out a10, that is 8. Minus 1 and 8. That means minus 1 and 8 is the correct option. So you have to be very careful. See, the slight change only in the signs. So you have to be careful and you have to tick the option. In today's class, we have completed this chapter, arithmetic progression, by solving 40 multiple choice questions. Practice well and do not forget to press like, share and subscribe.